Hello there, it's Dr. Patricia Coughlin again, talking to you about best practices and how to get a whole lot better at what you do as a psychotherapist. Last week, a colleague of mine, Dr. Monica Bertinussen from Norway, forwarded me a really interesting article that came out recently called Battles of the Comfort Zone. And this was a qualitative study of mentalization-based therapy with borderline patients. And the results were really interesting and I think shed some light on the very topic we're here to discuss, right? Best practices. What they found was that the most effective therapists, with this group of patients anyway, were able to rapidly identify destructive patterns of interaction that were typical of the patient, to see them in operation right there between therapist and patient, and then to challenge the patient to do it differently. Doing so was pretty uncomfortable, so these therapists actually did encourage patients to get out of their comfort zone in order to do something different, and as a result, they actually got the most positive outcomes. In contrast, therapists who were largely supportive actually got negative outcomes with this group of patients. So I think this underscores how important it is for us to assess not only what the patient's presenting problems are, like anxiety and depression, but their underlying character structure, so that we can formulate a detailed case conceptualization that will guide our interventions. The other important issue, really two other ones. One has to do with the role of anxiety in the process of change. Many therapists make the mistake of, again, being too supportive and lowering anxiety too much so that no change actually happens. The research suggests that moderate or optimal levels of anxiety are required for brain change and positive outcome in psychotherapy. So becoming skillful at knowing how to increase some anxiety and discomfort in patients who have low levels of anxiety and are perhaps stuck in their character defenses, and of course knowing how to rapidly and effectively lower anxiety if it gets too high, are really central skills, right, to learn and master. The other thing that I think this study, at least for me, really highlights is that it doesn't matter so much what you call what you do, whether you call it mentalization-based, CBT, compassion-focused, ISTDP. It's what are you actually doing? What are those critical factors associated with positive outcome? And I think we can see that here, even though they're calling it mentalization-based therapy, what they found was most important was challenging dysfunctional patterns and getting people out of their comfort zone. So there are lots of therapists who can do that, whether they call what they're doing mentalization-based or not. So I just wanted to share this study and the important factors that they discovered associated with positive outcome, at least with this group of borderline patients who are typically quite difficult to treat. So I hope you found it helpful, and I look forward to your feedback and your comments. Thanks. Until next time, bye-bye.